Hey everybody, it's Margaret, and I am coming to you this evening with a haul video. Most of it is a jewelry jar unboxing, but I went to the thrift store today to check it out. I was home with my son. My younger son was sick last night, so he ended up staying home today, and we had to get out of the house. So we went to Salvation Army and Goodwill. He's croupy. It's long story. I know he's six, but he still gets croup. I think it's airways or whatever. So we went, so he does okay during the day, but at night is just miserable. So we went today to Salvation Army, in which I did not buy anything. And then we went over to Goodwill, and he held out for a little bit, but they did have some jewelry jars there. And you guys know I'm just nuts for them. Lately, it seems like almost all I buy lately. So I spent $74. I bought three jars and then a few loose pieces. So I'll show you the loose stuff and the jars that I didn't unbox, and then the jar that I am unboxing for you today. Let me say hey in the chat real quick, and then we'll get started because I have some friends that really showed up. I don't know what happened. I set it for 8 and then it just said going live any minute, and I don't know why. So hey, Tracy HB Picker and Jazzy Red and Janina, how are you? And I'm scrolling down. Everybody's chatting. Hey, Guillermo and Latest Grace. And hey, Brian and Loretta. Hello. Hello from California, Leah or Lee. I'm not sure how you pronounce your name. And Yadira and Georgia Parka. Hello. I'm so glad you guys are doing well. So I was like a second late even then because my phone went to ching right as I went to hit live. And if you know me, I cross-post pretty much everything. So I had to quick go see what it was and then take it down over off of, it sold on Etsy. And so I had to take it down off of eBay. So hey, Christy Love and two dogs, three kids, four cats. Hi. Hi, Champagne and Lollipops. How are you? Okay, so I spent $74 today. And I think what really got me out the door, other than having a little one cooped up with me at home today, I'm doing a live show with J&A on Thursday night, and they want to talk jewelry. And so I've just been thinking jewelry again. So I was like, you know what? Let me go see what I find, because Jay said he's going to go out and look and see if he can find a jewelry jar. Nay was not sure she was going to be able to get out to do that. But I was like, you know what? Let me go see what I can find just on a whim. And I did tell Jay, don't buy anything that looks like junk. If it's just full of Mardi Gras beads, don't do it. Not even for the sake of the show. So so we'll see what he comes up with, because he's going to unjar it on air. So that'll be fun. So I got a few more people popping in. Hey, Chili and Guillermo, Aiken Soul. Hello, Nina. Nini. And let's see, the crazy card. I am a jar junkie. And hey, Catherine. And I know I saw Angie. There she is. Hey, Angie. Yeah, I have, and you know what the reason is that I can make my money back really quickly. Frequently, which is a perk for you and for me, I've had the last jar that I unboxed, the last jewelry, I don't even know if it was a jar, but the last jewelry haul I did, I made the money back to pay for the jar and then some just through viewers, which is not exactly why I do it, but it's a perk. Do I need an intervention? I thought so, but no. It would be one thing. Okay, I hoard some, so but it's just I haven't had time to list as much. So I'm making my money back, so that's good. And then you know, profit on top of that. So now I've just got to continue. I don't know. It's like the last that cross. If you watched me the other day, that cross that I got at the garage sale. If I hadn't gone, because I'm like, oh, I've got too much jewelry, I don't need to go. But then I showed up at the garage sale, you know, Thursday morning, and found a 10 karat gold and diamond cross for $8, you know? So you got to put yourself out there to find the really good finds. So yeah, it should be Latest Grace. Jason and jewelry should be fun, because Nay even says she doesn't do a lot of jewelry. So it should be really fun. Okay, so here we go. I spent $74 today, which is more than I like to spend, but it's one of those things when you see something that you want to buy, you gotta do it. And now here's the thing too, I want to bring up when I talk to J&A, is that It doesn't mean it's a fail if there's no gold in it. Or it, you know, it doesn't, some people will say, you know, oh, I didn't find anything good. I didn't find any gold or silver. But that doesn't mean that it's a, you know, not good, because a lot of times some of the costume jewelry pieces will sell for really good money. So I will show you the first jar I bought. And yeah, the first jar I bought was $24.99, which is kind of a lot because there doesn't seem to be a whole lot in here. But there were a few pieces that I thought were really nice. There's a bracelet there, this silver bangle. I haven't been able to determine yet if it's a silver tone bangle or a silver bangle. And then there was a watch in there too that I don't normally do watches, but it looked really high quality. So there's that. And then there's over here, you can see something that looks kind of like a Roman coin kind of hidden in there. And that it, I don't think it's silver, but I think that if, yeah, see, here we go. See it there? That coin look jewelry might bring, you know, a good amount of money to, not a good amount, not like a lot of money, but enough to start contributing towards paying for the jar. So I feel pretty good about this one that I'll, and then look, here's a leather. Wait, do you see that one? It's a nice thick leather strap, and then it's got a fishing hook on it. I'm about to turn this light off. It's already really hot in my workroom, so I'm already getting really flush. And then I have my light on because it's not as bright in here. But I'm about to turn this light off, so we may have to do it in the dark. Not like that, but like unbox it. Not in the dark, but you know, not as bright. I'm gonna turn off the light. So yeah, this really thick leather man kind of bracelet with a fishing hook on it. I think will also do okay, you know. So there's that one. Let me turn off the light. Let's get cozy. How about that? Hang on. Let me move my little table that you're sitting on. I'm gonna unplug my ear real quick. Hang on. Gotta climb out from all my mess. Yep, wrong one. There we go. I did okay, I'm back. It's not as bright, but you can still see me. I use that light when I take pictures in here now because my workroom is not as bright as the table. Oh boy, lots of people have shown up in the chat. But yeah, you can see my cheeks are already getting red. Whew. All right, let's see who's in the chat real quick and then we'll move forward. Or if I, yeah. Janine says, I bought a few jars, but no luck selling jewelry for some reason. I have to learn more about selling it. Yeah, I'm enjoying it. And I've had quite a few bits sell from some of the jewelry jars that I've actually listed, you know. And then let's see. Hey, Crafty Grandma. Hello. And yeah, $24.99 is generally what I see. The other two I think are $19.99 that I got. Yeah, around 20, 25 bucks. Like a piggy. I'm trying to get there, Angie. Let's see. Guillermo says Salvation Army had their jewelry bags for $100, not even a full bag. That's crazy. Yeah, I wouldn't do that. Okay, I'm hurrying, Diane. She's like, open, open, open. Okay, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. Hey, Leah. Okay. And hello, Nevada. Hey, Pat Henley. And okay, here we go. My little one's doing better. Randy's sitting with him in tonight. Hello from Australia. Hello, JBMC. Okay, so the other jar that I picked up, this is also one I'm not unboxing tonight. This one was $19.99. And then again, I found, you know, you see it doesn't have a lot of like beady things in it. But there were a few things in there that I really thought, okay, so like here, this one, I'm not sure it's really turquoise, but it looked promising, this turquoisey and silver bracelet. And I can't remember what else was in there. I see this little teddy bear. I don't know if you can see the back of it. This little teddy bear right there looks like sterling silver. I'll have to flip it around and see, is it on an earring or what? So there were a couple other things in there that looked promising. So that was $19.99. And then these are just random pickups. I picked up a totem pole, a little wooden totem pole, 49 cents. It's signed R. Gus. I have not looked it up yet, so maybe it'll be worth something. And then I picked up this bracelet with the butterflies on it. This also, the reason I picked this one up, if it had been a regular hinge with a spring in it, I probably wouldn't have picked it up. But I liked the closure because it's a, you have to push the button to open and close it. I don't know if you can see that. It's got a little push button open. and it clicks closed and then it stays closed. So for whatever reason, to me, that just said, you know, it's a little bit better quality. It's a little bit nicer. And so I chose to get it. And the price tag is not on it anymore, so I don't know what I paid for it. You know, it's Goodwill. So $1.99 maybe. I don't think it was that much even, because the other bracelet I got loose, I picked up some loose stuff. This one was 99 cents. And it's, you know, I don't think it's really turquoise. But again, the reason that I picked it up in here, listen to the closures, the hinges just sound kind of cheapy, but I may be totally wrong. Again, I'm not an expert, but again, the reason I picked it up was the clasp. So if you see, the clasp has got this little safety latch, and then you have to push the button, and then it releases it. And then it is marked FAS on the back, which stands for fused alloy silver, I believe. I don't know if you can see that, FAS, right there. So this is what that bracelet ends up looking like. It looks like it's trying to be turquoise, maybe dyed, but it's still really pretty. So, and I really like the catch on it. So, yeah, I do, Angie. I go a lot by the clinky sounds. I do. You hear it? It sounds clinky, not like silver. Okay. Oh boy, I'm trying to watch the chat and talk to you. All right, here we go. Random pickup sounds a lot worse than it is. This is true, Nevada. Jazzy says the butterfly bracelet looks 70s. Yeah, yeah. Okay, I'm going. All right. Uh-oh. There's no fighting, is there? There's no fighting in the chat. All right, here we go. Where did that one go? Okay. Oh, no, I got two more bags. Sorry. I'm just teasing. I'll get there. So these were some little earrings I also picked up, and they're piglet, but they're not really silver, I don't think. But I got them because they're like that hinged, you know, there's like three pieces, they're not hinged, but there's three bits, and it's like these piglet dangle earrings, and I didn't look close to see if, I don't think they're silver, but, well, I can pull my magnet and find out real fast. Well, yeah, they're not. So there's those little piglet earrings. I got those for 99 cents. I thought those were good for 99 cents. And I mean, I'm thinking at least $14.99 on those. I didn't research everything. I didn't have time. Sorry, guys. So there's that. And then I did get this little baggie full of studs, which I haven't really sold a lot of studs, but the reason I got them were these little filigree. I'm trying to see if you can see it through the bag. They're like little filigree butterflies, and they were not attracted to the magnet, but I haven't had time to look close to see if they're silver or not. And then I see this, something's got a mark on it. Okay, I see something with a mark right there on this little ball. Okay, sorry. I try to do as much research as I could beforehand, but then if I see a mark, you know I gotta jump in there and see. NR, I don't know what that means. Okay, never mind. Maybe it's nothing. Or is that Avon? Who knows? Okay, I'll look at those more closely later. Those were just part of the overall haul. Hey, Chicken Coop. Let's see. I got Mickey Mouse, like your piglet, just plain gold tone, says Disney on the back. Hard to take a pic because it was too reflective. Awesome. Okay, and then I apologize if this is wobbling because you're on a TV tray. You're on the TV tray in my workroom. Okay, so the other jewelry jar that I got, this is it. I paid $19.99 for it, and you would not think with this many beads and things in the bottom that I would have found anything awesome, but I did. So this is just the leftover, what's in the bottom. There were lots of craft, you know, like jewelry making stuff. So there were lots of these little beads. Clear beads, blue beads, then these ones are strung up, bagged ones, and then there were these wires. So, I mean, really nice, you know, some jewelry making stuff. So I threw that all back in there, and we'll see where that goes. And then the rest of everything I dumped and sorted into these containers here. That looked empty, but it's not. Here we go, like that. And it's in there. Okay. So, I'm going to go through like the necklaces and stuff first. And then I've sorted out a couple bits that I've researched to share with you guys. So, hey, we have 43 viewers. Hang on, let me scroll over here. Hello, Evilus. Hopefully I'm saying your name right. Hello, hello. 44 viewers, if you could hit that like button, I would really appreciate it. I'm flying solo, so I don't have a partner to yell it out for me. All right, so here we go. Let's jump into this bit, and then I'll pull some of the items that I have researched. So one of the bits that were in there, that was in there, sorry, is this beaded necklace. And then it's got some that have string throughout them. And then it's on this ribbon. So some of these things I'm guesstimating on my prices because I didn't get a chance to look them up. So I may be high, I may be low, I may be way off. But then also in the chat, if you know more, I love to hear it because I need help sometimes too. You know, nobody knows everything. So here's this one. And I'm thinking this would probably go for, you know, $12.99, $14.99, somewhere in that range. Pretty cool. Hello, Vintage Maid. Hello, Christy Love. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Do I keep the beaded stuff? No, not really. Eventually, I'll put it in a lot. Eventually. Okay. Just ask Chad. He's the jewelry expert. That's what he says. We'll make sure we ask him. Okay, and then we've got a pink, like, beaded shell type necklace. And then this one, again, will probably go in my shop for $7.99, somewhere in that range. So that's pretty cool. Chad said, no, LOL. He's just kidding. So then this next one that was in the jar is a leather. It's on a leather strap. It's got this flower with a little another flower in the middle. And then I'm not sure about this. So I mean, I kind of base it on, do I think it's awesome or not? If I haven't done the research. And then I do find sometimes when I go research it, some things are more awesome than I think they are. But I'm guessing on this one, it's going to be on the lower end. I might even put this one in a lot because I'm not loving it a whole lot. So, I mean, $7.99, $9.99, that's my low end. So, Aching Soul says, is your shop online or at a flea market or something? What part of Texas am I in? So my stuff goes on Etsy or eBay or and eBay, depending. And I'm in the Houston area of Texas. So that's a cute one. Me too. I like it. Yeah. So yeah, again, if you see something that you like, you can message me, TexasGalTreasures@gmail.com, or catch me on Facebook. And I'm happy to work out a deal. So, and that happens a lot. Somebody will see something that I hold up and I don't think it's that awesome, but they do. And then it's win-win. Okay, so next up, this is really kind of cool. It's a cross, but it's really abstract. Take a look. It's got all these like round bits. I think it's supposed to be a cross. It's kind of got these teal blue and then bling. I wouldn't even know how to describe it. And then it's on this light blue leather strap. And then the only problem is the clasp is gone. So I think this is cool enough that it would sell. But I think I would have to fix the strap. I mean, yeah, I'll have to do something to fix that because I really think that this, you know, could go for closer to the $17.99, $19.99 mark. I think it's pretty cool. Yeah. Angie said, would you call that steampunk? Possibly. Steampunk Christian, right? That's got to be a niche out there. A niche? I'm making a new word here. Niche? All right, let's see. I'm looking in the chat real quick. So, yeah, okay, there's that. And I didn't average everything out. The whole thing was $19.99, so everything is less than a dollar because there's more than 20 pieces in here. Again, another little shell necklace. I have, you know, you find one of these probably in almost every jar. So I may just lot them all up for something, for somebody who may want them. Okay. Then a little stretchy bracelet. This will probably also go into a lot like that. I have a few things that'll probably go into a lot. This one as well, it's kind of tangled. It's one of those bottle cap. Somebody made it. Looks a little H. These are all kind of tangled up. They're tangled up. So that will also end up in a lot. If you see something and you're like, don't put that in a lot. Yeah, say it. Don't put that in a lot. That'll sell by itself. Okay, this one kind of reminds me, there were some pink beads that I sold from another jar for like $12.99, and I couldn't believe it because they were like pink mottled like plasticky beads. And they sold for, yeah, like $12.99. And so they were similar to this, except for the background was more pink. And then this one has got a little pendant on it. So it looks awfully small. I don't think that would fit me. So this, I'm thinking I'm going to list this probably close to the $10, $12 mark. I think there were earrings in there to match that because I recognize the little pearly bead at the on the pendant right there. Let's see. Chicken Coop says, beach necklaces could be cute party favors for girls' pool parties and birthday parties. This is such a good idea, right? And another thing I do is like blingy rhinestone stuff. I've been saving, I have like a whole tub full of that stuff, like faux pearl, faux rhinestones that I'm going to put to make like a little princess party lot to sell. So we'll see how that goes. I haven't done it yet. We'll see. Okay, so again, this one probably around that $10, $12 mark as well. When you think about it, like, oh, that's not that great. You know, I wouldn't buy this on its own. But in the jar, if I'm trying to make my $20 back, you know, I've kind of already done it. But I have got some pieces here that have made it. So I'll show you. All right, so the next, I'm trying to figure this one out. I'm looking for these are the ones that always get me because I can never figure out where's the back. I think that's the back, like that. And then it's these multi-strand. I think it's not right. But it's kind of neat. I mean, girls, you know, they like this kind of stuff. I don't wear a lot of this kind of stuff. But yeah, it's got these multi-strand. I'll have to fix it. Oh, boy. There we go. All right. There. So yeah, I think this one, and again, I'm just guesstimating because I don't know. I didn't look this one up. At least $14.99, $12.99, $14.99, somewhere in that range. So, Georgia says I keep getting kicked off. I'm not sure why. Sorry. You too? Okay, I'm not kicking anybody out. Okay, next is a beaded necklace, which looks really like a vintage beaded necklace. This looks like something I would have made, you know, with my little bead set when in the 80s, you know, as a little girl. So there's that. And it's got one of those barrel screw closures. So again, this one will probably go around that $9.99, $7.99 mark. I may be smoking it with this one, but I'm going to try it because I think somebody's going to be nostalgic. We'll see. But that's the thing. Every time I think I may be smoking it, with that, you know, I think back to that pink beaded necklace that just looked like a plain old pink beads and sold for $12.99. So, Clear and Clutter says, looks like a necklace my boss bought me from Nepal. Interesting. Who's that? There goes Donald again. Do you follow Donald Trump on Twitter? Let's just not talk about it. I'll just mute him. Okay, so there's that. We don't talk politics. Anyway, I'm joking. I'm not really smoking, but it's just a turn of phrase, right? You know, dreaming big. Hey, Jeff, you came in just in time. Aching Soul, what happened with your $12.99 pink bead necklace? Yeah, it was just a pink beaded necklace that I thought was like a throw, you know, I was going to go into a lot, but I said, you know what? Let me see what'll happen. And I ended up listing it and it sold. So. Yeah. Hey, Casey. Okay, so this one's kind of cool. So it's got these, and somebody in the last video told me what these kind of beads were called. And now I can't remember. I'll have to go back and look. But then, look. Here is the necklace, the pendant. Dun, 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 dun. Look at him. It's like this lion, and he's all inlaid. So he's got these, it's kind of hard to tell, but his eyes are those abalone shell, and he's all inlaid. He's really cool. Here's the back. Like that. The sticker was on his back from before that. Coconut shell. Maybe that's... Come on, Ange. She said they're called brown. They're brown. Yeah, okay. But anyway, he's super cool. I really like him. And I think he's going to do well. I wish it would pick up his eyes because his eyes really shimmer with that abalone shell. So I'll have to figure out the rest of what he's called, not just orange and brown. So yeah, this is again another one I did not look up. But I'm willing to think that he's going to be worth more than the, $12.99. I'm thinking I may put him closer to $17.99 unless I find out something really awesome about him, and then it will be more. So rawr, there he is. So that's cool. Let me show you one of the things that I did look up, sort of. So this is a bracelet. It's a multi, kind of bangle, but it's not. It's a cuff. And I had one of these similar to this in one of my last jewelry jars, and it sold. So I was going to pull up the sale so you could see what I was talking about. And here we go. Here it is. So this one sold for me on eBay, but I think it was on sale and it ended up selling for like 11, something like that. So I feel pretty confident putting this at that same price point around $14.99, because this other one sold close to that. I mean, no, it's not exactly the same, but it's pretty similar. And it didn't take that long to sell, maybe a couple of weeks. So that will go up for $14.99 like that. That's, I mean, and then if you think about, well, what do I have into it? Maybe a buck after fees and everything, my profit, maybe $7 or $8. So Angie says she likes that one better. Hey, One Witch Lady, hello. Yeah. Uh-oh, Lindsay says I'm conflicting with other programming. Oh no, and I checked with people to make sure I wasn't going to be like, ask if Chad's still there, ask him. I messaged him. You going live tonight? I just want to make sure I'm not like bumping up, not bumping up against anybody. Everything I say sounds wrong tonight. Maybe this is why I don't record in the evenings. Puka shell. There we go. Yeah, maybe this is why I don't record at night. Okay, so next up, who else is live? Because now I feel bad because I really try not to conflict with anybody. No, Angie, not at all. Okay, so this one looks like somebody made it. It's there we go, and it's got these nice little beads, and then it's got a cross and a little hang tag that reads hope on it, which is really cute. So I think that will, I like the necklace. I like the cross. I don't so much like the little hang tag. Wonder if I could take it off. Yeah, it's on a jump ring. Tell me what you think. If this would sell better, because it looks nice, but then the little hang tag, like the little jump ring, kind of makes it look not as nice. So there, if it's like that, I kind of like it better, right? What do you think? So this one without the hope, or I mean, not without the hope. You want the hope. But yeah, I think off looks cute. So that's another one that I will for sure sell. This is really, I mean, this is a fairly good jar. There's not a whole lot that I would put in a lot. So this one probably again around that $14.99, $17.99 price point. Boy, they're all over the place. Okay, focus, focus. Oh, Prof. Sales, sorry, I'll have to tell Jason sorry because I really don't like to go up. I'm not trying to go up against Jason. Anyway, so yeah, there's that $14.99, $19.99, somewhere in that price point. Let me check the chat real fast. All right, so oh, Nicole was live too. I didn't know that. Darn. Oh well, I tried. I tried not to. I need another word. I tried not to parallel anybody. All right, so where does the jewelry sell better for me, eBay or Etsy? Honestly, it's kind of a tie, but I mean, eBay's been doing pretty well, and then a few things have been selling on Etsy as well. As far as taking the tag off, Nevada says take it off. A few people say leave it on, mostly says take it off. Christine and Angie are having a laugh about me bumping and smoking. Oh boy. All right. Looks more expensive without it. That's what I thought, Christine, right? I thought that, yeah, that's what I thought. But a few people said, yeah. You know what? Maybe it's something that I'll take it off And then when they buy it, I can just, you know, throw it in their bag to take it with them. Words, so that they can add it if they choose to later. Okay, quick drink. My throat's getting dry. If I didn't know you guys liked me, I would wonder. But yeah, now Jeff's jumping in with Angie and Christine. Bumping, what did they say? Smoking, bumping, and taking it off. That's right. Okay, moving forward. No, it is not vodka. This is water. Okay. So here we go. This is another, I tend to pick these up. I love picking up shark's tooth necklaces, but mostly because my boys like them. But if you guys know, I'm a big rock hound. I love rocks, minerals, fossils, things like that. I've got a little one over here, one of my little ones. And I pick them up at garage sales, estate sales, thrift stores, because if you go to a rock and mineral store, you know how expensive these are. So there we go. And I have, yeah, like I say, I have a collection, but I just pick them up from thrift stores and garage sales and things. So yeah, I tend to pick these up because I'm into that kind of thing. I can't look at my friends in the chat. Okay. So yeah. So I pick these up. I don't know that I'll sell it. My boys probably have 3 shark's tooth necklaces each that I have thrifted or picked up at garage sales. So yeah, I may look into selling this one. It's really hard for me to part with that kind of thing. It really is. Okay. All right. So now I'm looking back in the chat. I'm really trying to move forward, but they're making me laugh and I need it today. So Nicole was just live, but she ended too. Okay. I didn't know. I really don't want to go live with other people. Everything sounds bad now that they're poking me in the chat. Casey says, y'all be respectful. She's a Southern lady. Yes. Yes. That's right, friends. But I know they're my friends and they're just teasing me. And then Thrift Daddy says, Golden Finger Picker loves fossils because he is one. And yeah. Chrissy says, my boys buy them at a local gem and mineral show auction. That would be awesome. My guys would love that. They really would. They got some little geodes that they got to crack open. So did I finish testing all those buttons? No, I didn't. Are those actual teeth or stones? I don't know. I'm just going to sit here and look at the chat because I'm having trouble moving forward. So yeah, I'm not done testing all the rest of the buttons from the Bakelite button, which may end up being Lucite. So we'll see. I may have to redo it. All right. Next up, moving forward, I'm going to hide the chat a little bit, not all the way. So this necklace was also in there, which would have been really, really nice. But it is missing a couple stones, so it will end up in a lot. That will go into a lot. And let's see what else we've got over here. Another really long necklace. This one's kind of pretty, but I don't know what to make of that. It's got different things. It's not symmetrical, and I'm really into symmetry. So it's got these beads on this side. It's got this flower on this side. Again, this will probably, I don't know, maybe it'll go $14.99, $17.99, somewhere like that. I didn't see any kind of marks or anything, labels on it. I missed something, so I don't know what they're talking about. And then there's a cute little keychain, and it's got a gingerbread man on it. Let's see if it'll focus. It won't focus for you. It says, Jesus warms my heart. So it's a little gingerbread man. This would have been good during Christmas in somebody's, you know, stocking. Okay, so again, that will probably end up in a lot. And this necklace, again, I'm not sure about this one. I've never seen anything quite like it. So it looks like somebody made it, and it's got these red and blue plastic but metallic beads, and then it's got, you know, there are crosses then throughout the rest of it. So it's different. So I don't know. This is one of those that I'm like, I may just try to sell this, you know, just to see, because I've never really seen anything quite like it. So I might end up putting this up, you know, again, just to see what happens with it. Maybe at $12.99. just because, just like, yeah, like I said, the pink beads, anything will sell. She says, you will sell that for $21.99. The blue and red one? You think so? I will take that. I will take that as gospel, Angie. All right, so next up, like the other plastic beads. There we go. Okay. So here we have just a gold tone chain. I'm not sure what that kind of link is called. He says, I missed this. This jar was $19.99. So I'm not sure what kind of link this is. I don't know. If you know what that is called, I mean, I'll probably put like faceted, something like that. And then I didn't check it with the, yeah, it's magnetic. So, but it's, I mean, it's different. It's not like just a normal gold tone chain. So I may still try to sell this one. I'm, again, didn't look it up. So this one will probably go for $14.99. It's one of those, I'll put it up with best offer because I just don't know. Let's see. So yeah, this, somebody said 24, one of the jars that I picked up was $24.99, then two of them were $19.99. The one I'm going through now is $19.99. Clearing Clutter says, I like the gold necklace. It looks like Lucky Brand style. Oh, does it? Okay. I'll have to look closer to see if there's any markings. Because I know sometimes Lucky Brand has a mark on it. So I'm going to take a drink of my not vodka, friends. All right, here we go. So now I'm going to pull something that I did research because I have a few things to the side that I researched. And this is a set. This is the pendant. And it's on a sort of a satin type cord, like so. And it has the look of, you know, the jewelry that people make out of silver spoons and forks and things like that. Now they're telling me to drink. So it's got a necklace and then there's a matching earring set. And it has that look of silver, like silverware. But this is made by Avon. You've got to stop looking at them. So these are made from Avon, which normally, you know, Avon stuff, no, you don't really. But I think these will sell just because of the look of them. And then let's see what I pulled up. Let me pull up what I found. I found the earrings on an from an Etsy seller, but they were on vacation. So if you know Etsy, you can put your, I guess you can put your store on vacation on eBay as well. So here, you know, somebody's selling them. So I can't see what they, what they are selling them for because they are on vacation. So that's a question mark right there. But this one is similar. It's like that similar style, and it's also an Avon one. I was trying to get an idea. They have theirs up for about $10. So I'm thinking for the set, here are some other Avon earrings anyway. Let me look over here and see. Yeah, I'm looking for a set. I've never really been successful with selling sets, but who knows? Someone has got this set, Avon set, for $16. But I think I might put $20 on this set just because. I mean, it's got a cooler look than this, I think. $20, $24.99, somewhere in that range. Maybe $24.99 was the best offer. So, all right. I think they enjoy seeing me get flustered. It does look like Brighton, right? Clearing clutter for clarity. It has that Brighton look. It has that silver spoon look. But it is Avon brand. So yeah, I think it'll do okay. And maybe those people will come back from vacation and I'll be able to see what they're selling theirs for. So there's that. Okay, here we go. So around $24.99, which if that sells at that price would pay for the jar, you know? Moss Family Adventures asked, where did you get that? I got it from the jewelry jar. Jewelry jar. That I bought. Okay, let's see. Gosh, I'm not reading that anymore. Angie, I got a necklace with a tag that has SR. Okay, no. Okay. There we go. Okay, let's move forward. So next up, a little watch was in there, and it's got a palm tree. I mean, this just looks, no, this will end up in a watch lot that I keep talking about doing, which I have not done yet. And then a silver tone bead necklace, which I will list. It's really, you know, it's vintage and it's got quite a bit of wear, but I think somebody might want it. I mean, I sold a necklace today that was kind of like antiqued metal, and then it had like a pearl strand that I got from a jar, and that sold today on Etsy. I can't remember how much it sold for. Let me look real fast. Or I sold it yesterday and I shipped it out today. What did it sell for? But it was from a jar, and now of course it's not pulling up when I'm asking it to. So then the person messaged me and said, hey, you know, I do a steampunk. There was some steampunk thing that she was going to, and she thought it would go well with her outfit. But it sold for $24.99 out of a jar, you know, and it was that, like I say, antiqued metal look. And so I think, you know, this might kind of go in that same vein. So I might put that up for $24.99 as well, just to see. Hey, Celia, Happy New Year. Hello. He says, if you ever find any more Dutch stuff, let me know. I will. All right, then here's another little bracelet. It's got these silver tone, I guess they're swirly suns. I will sell that because there are people that are into that kind of style. Like Tanya loves the starburst look. You know, there are people that really are into this kind of like tribal swirly sun look. So that I will put up again, probably $14.99 range. So, I mean, when you look at the items that way, yeah, when enough of them sell at that range, you'll make your money back. But of course, you're trying to find at least one, and there is a wow item that I'm saving for the end. So hang in there. Boy, I'm not going very fast. How long have we been live? Because I got to start picking up the pace. I'm looking to see. Oh, boy. Okay, I got to start picking up the pace. Seriously, we've already been at it for close to an hour. Here we go. We've got some bangles. Those will end up in a lot because they're just little bangles. We have got this woven cuff bracelet with wood and metal. And this one I will sell probably around the $14.99 mark. Let's see. Another little bangle with hearts on it. I will list this by itself. Again, probably for $9.99. I didn't see a mark on it. And then this cute little enamel one, I'll probably take a closer look at. It's got, you know, this white enamel in there. Pretty cute. I love bangles, so I'm a sucker for them. And then this sort of crushed stardust sort of looking gold bangle, gold tone, will end up being sold as well. So brass, maybe, possibly. Okay, so then next up, I'm trying to pick up the pace. There are three little stretchy bracelets here, and those I will sell together. I'll probably put $11.99 on those, $12.99. Those are pretty cute. These will probably go into a lot, I think. Tell me what you think, if you think I shouldn't, because I don't know. They don't, again, that's one of those things. It's not my style, but it might be somebody's style. They're that stretchy kind of, yeah, I don't know. So there's that. And then just some more of those little bangles. I'm trying to go a little bit quicker because I wasn't planning on being here for more than an hour. But I get to talking with people and it's all over. A little necklace with a Scrabble tile that will go into a lot. I don't think that chain is, no, it's not silver. Okay. Then a friend's brace necklace, and the necklace is marked Claire's, so that will also end up in a lot. I think I did sell, or not sell, but I did list a vintage Claire's charm bracelet this week. So not necessarily, you know, if it's marked Claire's, it doesn't necessarily mean it's automatically out the door. So I haven't sold it yet, but I did list it. I'm optimistic. And then this little bracelet, I may try to sell this. It's pretty cute. Little charm bracelet. I feel like I'm saying little a lot. Just, I don't know. Kind of a tribal look. So I think someone might like that. It's got the toggle closure. So that I will try to sell. Also, all right, tell me what you think about this one, you guys. This, I think, may be a necklace, but maybe not. It may be, I don't even know. So it's got these plastic crystal-looking stones. They're pokey on one side, you know, they're pointy on one side and flat on the other side. And they're connected with these metal bits. But it feels like it would be painful to wear. Like if the wrong end were laying on you, you know, I mean, maybe it's fine, but I don't know. Oh, now it's apart. Okay, now it's a long bit. Maybe it's, I don't know. So yeah, chandelier beads, somebody says. So I'll list them. I'll list them. I don't know. Yeah. Looks like it's from a chandelier. Probably, but I think people use them, don't they? For crafts and whatnot. I'll look into it. I'll look into it. Again, this one will most probably, yeah, this is a Claire's piece necklace. This will go into a lot. It's kind of cute, but I don't, yeah, no. And then this one has missing stones, so it will be lotted up. Let me check that. If the necklace part is silver, I'll just pull the, if this part is silver and this part is, you know, it's missing stones, then I'll take this necklace off to put with another pendant. Let me, yeah. So it's not, the necklace is not magnetic. There's a possibility. I'll have to check it closer to see if it's silver. Okay, moving quicker. All right, one witch lady says she sells chandelier pieces all the time. Good, okay, that's good to know. So here is a wishbone necklace. I will sell this. It is not, okay, here's the thing. The necklace I did test because it looked promising, but the necklace is magnetic, and so it is not silver, but the wishbone is not magnetic, but it's not marked. So I'll have to check it out, you know, a little closer. But I'll still sell it. I think somebody would like that. People are into Lucky Charms and things like that. So this one will probably go up in my shop for, you know, around that $14.99 mark. Maybe more, $17.99, somewhere in there. And then, okay, I'm trying to think of the name of this style. It's sort of an enamel, but it's swirled. If you can remember, Angie, what that's called, I would appreciate the help. Marbled sort of look. On this brooch, I don't think it's vintage because, I mean, if it is vintage, somebody's repurposed it because that is hot glued, looks like, on there, maybe. So that I will still try to sell. Again, $17.99, unless I find something that is more, you know, if I find something, I haven't researched it, so that's my guess. Maybe $24.99. It's kind of pretty. I mean, it would really, if you were wearing a black jacket or something like that. Oh, Peace3601 says, love the pictures you take on your listings. They could be in a magazine. Thanks so much. It was a learning process, that's for sure. My early pictures, not so much. Okay, next, let me show you another bit that I have researched that I found in the jar. I found these little earrings, and they're adorable. Hello, Michelle. They are sterling silver ladybug earrings, and they are super, super cute. So yeah, they're sterling silver. They're marked. And let's screen share real fast. Here we go. Ta-da! So here are some on Etsy. And I'm looking on Etsy. I look some on eBay. I look kind of all over to get my prices. I know some people say you've got to look at the eBay solds, but I don't really go off of those. I look at them, but I don't necessarily base everything off of them. So don't I wish they were vintage David Anderson Norway, but no, I don't think so. So, but mine are really nice, and they're sterling silver, and they're enameled. So, I mean, these ones are $28 down here, which is, I'm looking for some other similar kind of ones. Mine are cuter than these, I think. Mine look more vintage than these, that's for sure. So I'm thinking I will probably put them, you know, $21.99, $24.99, somewhere in that mark, because they're really cute and super vintage. They have a bit of a tarnish on them. So that's what I think about those. That's what I think. Okay, so now I'm jumping into my other one with my smalls. The rest are like earrings and little bits like that. I may not show you everything because I really don't want to go past an hour. I'm trying not to. So I'll move kind of quicker. But I pulled a lot. There was a lot out in this one. Picked up these earrings. They're not marked, but they're not magnetic. I think they're silver. So here's, I mean, the finishings. So if you can see, it's got like this sort of ball joint that hooks through and then it opens up like that. And then at the tip, you can see where it's way more, it looks white to you probably, but that's just where it's not tarnished. So I think they're silver based on that, but I'll have to test them and check. So there's those, and I didn't look them up, but I think I could get probably $20 for those earrings. I think. So there's those ones. I'm kind of skipping through stuff. Sorry. I spent too much time talking to friends. These ones, which are, they're not silver, but they're really nice. I like that green enamel and the silver tone. They're kind of chandelier looking. Yeah, the other ones look 80s style. So those ones, again, I'll probably put these at $24.99. Kind of cute, but they're not my style. So those will go up. And then these are nice as well. They are silver. I don't know if they're sterling silver, but they're not magnetic, so they may be stainless steel. I didn't look at them super close. And the little balls move. So those ones I'll put up. I don't even know. But they're neat. They're cute. So those I'll probably put up, you know, $14.99, depending what I find out there. I'm going a bit too fast now. Let me know. When I first started, before I hit live, I was like, I always end up talking way so fast. And I thought, okay, just take your time. And then I take my time. I took my time too much. So here's another pair that I will list. Again, these are not my style. They look kind of like door knockers. But these may be somebody else's style, and I will probably put these up, you know, at $17.99, $14.99, somewhere in that range. Okay. Again, another pair that didn't test magnetic, but I didn't see any marks on them, so I'll have to look at them a little bit closer. Those earrings, silver loopy earrings. And then these have that Western look, so those will do pretty well, I think. Again, I didn't see a mark on them, but I'll probably put those around the $20 mark. Okay, let me pull up another pair that I did look up so I can share with you. Hello, Karen! How are you? So here I've got these that look like little cowboy boots, and they have a star where the spurs go, and they are marked 925. And then, okay, I saw this mark on something else. Let's see if you can see it. It's like an M, and it looks like a curve around, like, but it doesn't complete an O, so I'm not sure. I'll have to look that mark up because I couldn't find it in my short time of researching. So let me share with you what I did find. All right. Let's see, where did they go? Not those ones. Here we go. So the closest I found were these that have a cowboy hat attached to them, but mine do not have the hat. But personally, I wouldn't want the hat. I would just want the... So it's just personal preference. So there's these that have, you know, almost identical that are selling for $30. So I may still put mine. I mean, those are $38. Which other ones? I mean, these aren't exactly, some of these are not exactly the same as mine, but I'm just kind of looking at what they're going for. So I may still put mine, I might put mine around the, you know, $25 mark, because I think, you know, those little stars that are dangling there will be a, they'll sell it. I really do. Okay, so those ones I'll probably put up around the $25 mark. Hey, Friegel, how's it going? I'm not sure. I'm sure I'm not saying you're right. Green Pastures, hello. Hello. Okay, and then here's some other ones that I'm going to sell. These have that kind of antiqued copper brass look. And then these ones were interesting, but I'm not sure. They're interesting, but then the words throw me. So it's a star and it's got bling on it, but then it looks like somebody carved believe in it and just kind of like used some glitter glue and finished it off. They would have been really cool without that. But again, not I will list them. They're not my style, but they're somebody's style. So those ones I'll probably put up again around $14.99. And I think they'll sell. I think so. I'm trying to skip some of the little ones. But hey, Malaya, how are you? Kind of steampunk, yeah. These are just some little black stone ones. They'll probably end up in a lot. And these, it's missing one of the little beads, but those will end up in a lot probably. Oh, these ones were cute. These ones are really cute. Hey, Vintage Thrifter. These ones are super duper cute. Okay, so these are some earrings, and they're like little shoes with this Dalmatian print, and they have like this little kitten heel. I'm trying to show it to you. You see, that's the profile of them. Then they have this little teeny heel, and then it's even hollow through there where the toes would poke through, and they look like, you know, Dalmatian little. They're super cute. They're teensy. So yeah, I will for sure list those. Because that's got quite an audience, people who love shoes, people who love Dalmatians, people who love Disney, 101 Dalmatians, I'm guessing. So yeah, those ones, Cruella de Vil, those are your shoes. So I will probably, I'll have to do some research, but my gut is like, put them up at like $24.99. Go crazy with them, because I think somebody's going to just look at them and say, I have to have them. I have to have them. I haven't seen anything like that. And then these ones, again, I will also sell. I'm going to need some help probably from my group later to describe them. So they've got a lot going on. We'll just put it that way. But some ladies have a lot going on. So then, so for sure, I've already made my money back, just bits and pieces. But I've got three more things that I've researched that I'm going to show you in just a second. These ones as well, I think will do well if I can hold on to them. They're fun. They're stars and stripes, hearts, like so. They're really patriotic. Ta-da! And again, I'll probably put these around the $14.99 mark. I really like them. You know, you see a lot of stuff kind of like that, but I think mine look better. They kind of remind me of Wonder Woman. I don't know why. Maybe it's this part. It's getting late, y'all. It's getting late. Let's see. I like you better with no hat. I don't know the last time I wore a hat. Maybe you're talking to somebody else. Okay, so maybe you mean headband. These ones I will probably list as well. Looks like somebody homemade them, but I'm a sucker for cloisonné, and they have two little cloisonné beads right there. So those will list probably around $10. I mean, not a whole lot. Alrighty. I'm trying to zoom through the rest. Okay, tell me what you think this is. So there's this, which I thought was just a button, but it's got a snap on the back. Anybody seen something like that before? I haven't. So I don't know what that goes to. That would be cute as a barrette. Put shield in the title. Yeah, there we go. They do. They look like a bust, those hearts. All right, so that, I don't know what is going on with the snap and what the snap goes to. So if you know, let me know. I'm trying to see. These are kind of cool, kind of mod earrings with chains and just a white ball on them. So yeah, those will, I'll sell those by themselves, probably again, $10 mark. Let me show you one of the things I've looked up, and then I'll dive into my last little, I'm on the last little doohickey. See, button cover, but how is it a button? I mean, I guess there would have to be a backing for it, for the button cover. I don't know. Okay, so next bit. These are really cute as well. So these are little gold tone watering cans. And I did find the same ones. I don't see any markings on them, but I'll have to look a little bit closer because I found some that are exactly like them that are listed as gold plated. But that doesn't mean anything because, you know, somebody's listing could be wrong. So here we go. Let's see. These ones right here, watering can 24 karat gold. Oof. 24-karat gold plate. You better have some proof to back that up right there. Anyway, but they're only selling for $11. So I kind of feel like they would go for higher than that, you know? So these little watering cans, I may still put at $14.99 because I think they're adorable and I think somebody's going to want them because they're into their gardening. I do. Kitty catchers. Okay. Keyword gardening. Yeah, yeah. Okay, and then there were two of these. I'm guessing they're stainless steel little rings, which I will sell. And I'm not sure how much for, but I really think that they will sell. So I'm going to double check on what I think the price will go for those. And then there's a little gold tone peace heart ring. It is magnetic. I tested that. So was it? No, it's not magnetic, but I don't think it's gold. I didn't see any markings. Not magnetic. I'll look at it closer later. So there's that. I didn't see any markings just straight off. This one is marked Avon. I was kind of hoping it would be something good because I see somebody's put a ring sizer in there, unless it came with that. So this is a little, it looks like a buckle Avon ring. Again, didn't look it up. And a mood ring. It's a cute little mood ring. A little cross. It looks like somebody made this. Little cross on a ring like so. I probably will put this in a lot. And then somebody at the store must have tied these together, or maybe the person who donated them. There were stacking, little stacking rings, which I will probably sell, you know, even if it's just $9.99 for these three little rings like that. Let's see. The white ball earrings were kitty bait. This is probably true. Yeah, my kitties would like them. And then there were three, I was playing with these earlier, three little just silvery rings. Again, I didn't see any markings on them, but they're cute as a stacking set. The boot earrings with no hat. Okay. And then a little blingy ring. It's really cute. I was kind of, this is actually one of the things I saw that I made me buy the jar, but it is magnetic, but it's still really, really cute. It's just this little blingy ring that I was kind of hoping was real, but no. But that's okay. I have two more things to show you that I looked up, and one of them saves the day, even though, is brass magnetic? Good question. I don't know. So these ones are some silver cactus earrings, and they are not marked, so I'm not sure they're sterling silver. My gut tells me they're not, but they may be like that kind of alpaca type silver. I'm not sure. So I will test them and let's see what I found out about them. Chicken Coop says, love those watering cans. Aren't they cute? Okay, so here we go. That's those ones. That's the ladybugs. All right, so I think, you know, there was somebody had some Western jewelry for sure. These are on eBay. Pardon me, I'm gonna take a quick drink real quick. Pardon me. This is one of the reasons I don't like to go off of these. These are the sold. And I'm not liking these prices, you know? I think I can get more for my earrings than some of these. Like, I think they could have gotten more for that. Really? I think you could have gotten more. So I will probably put mine closer to the $19.99 mark because I don't mind waiting for the right buyer to come along. Yeah. It's rodeo's coming up. They just announced the Houston rodeo schedule. So now, okay, this is the piece. I saw the back of it when I bought the jar. This is the back of it. Any guesses? Anybody in the chat or later? Okay. Oh, that just gave it away, sort of. All right. So if you can see the back, this is the other reason I bought this. So this piece, if you see down here again, this has got that James Avery candelabra, and James Avery is big in Texas. I don't know if it is where you are. Let me see if I can polish it up a little bit so you can see it a little better. rubbing off some of this tarnish. You can't really see it much better, but there's a little candelabra there, and this one says JA925. Sometimes it says Avery, sometimes I'll say Avery Sterling, and then this, the front of it says, God be with us together and apart, and it is on a James Avery leather strap, and it's in pretty good shape. I mean, the strap is, and then the pendant as well, the charm is in pretty good shape. I mean, it's tarnished a bit, but that's okay. So let me share with you. Vintage Thrifter says, just listed a JA cross. Yeah. And this, you know, they'll sell. And then if it's retired, even better, you know? Okay, so I'm just going to show you the James Avery store. So this is the leather cross, the cord that I have. And I was thinking, okay, well, yeah, that's a long one, $44. You know, mine's maybe 16 inches. Mine's not that long. But even the 16-inch ones, the price is the same. It's $44 new, which is bonkers, but it is. And then here is the charm, because it's still, it's not retired. So the charm is also $39. So who would have thought, first of all, who would have thought that the cord is worth more than the charm, right? Not me, but now I know. So here's what I'm thinking. I'm going to sell it on the cord, and let me pull up this. Let's see. They usually have another part, right? Yeah. Okay, so here's the cord. Are these sold? Let me scroll back. Okay, here's sold. And I'm looking for one. I don't think mine is 18 inches, but I don't have it. I didn't measure it. Maybe it is, but it's pretty short, so I'm guessing it's 16. So these are just, you know, here's the cord, 18 inches, sold for $34.99. Yep. You know, somebody sold $44, just the cord. 16-inch cord, $23.95. Okay, awesome. And then here's the charm. These are sold, you know, $22, $26, $20. So I will, yeah, I'll probably sell the pair. I'll put the pair up for probably $50 with the cord. Ta-da! Yay! So that was the big winner out of the jar, right there. And the weird thing is I'm in that Goodwill all the time. And so I look at their loose jewelry and I never saw this. You know, normally it's like the loose jewelry that hasn't sold, they throw into the jar and all that. But maybe they just got up so much that they just started filling jars. I don't know. So yeah. So there we go. That one will pay for everything. So, okay. Julie says, so glad to see this, came home before work. Oh no, I'm sorry, you're sick. Oh no. Okay, so we have 47 viewers right now. Hi, Turtle Trader. Yeah, Angie, I do find a lot of James Avery. Actually, one of the last jewelry jars I did, somebody saw it and bought the pendant straight away. So I was really happy about that. We have 48 viewers. If you could hit the thumbs up button. And also, I posted another video earlier today. I have a jewelry giveaway going on right now. You have to go and enter on my not my Facebook page, but my website. So I have a link. So you have to go enter on the website because I'm trying to do it right on, you know, YouTube rules and whatnot. So one witch lady said, never heard of James Avery till I watch you. Yeah, something to look out for. So yeah, go over some, a jewelry company sent me some jewelry to review and, you know, some to, for me to keep, some to review, and I've decided to just give it all away. So it's 6 pieces I'm giving away. And so go enter, and I'm drawing tomorrow because last time I let it go for too long. I had like too many entries. I couldn't, yeah. So go enter. I'm going to draw tomorrow, probably around 2 o'clock, and give those pieces away. So I'd love for somebody who watches me regularly or that I see all the time to win, because you know how it goes. Anyway, so thanks so much, you guys. Make sure you hit that like button. And if you have not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button and watch me or find me Thursday on Jason's channel, Thrifty Business with J&A. And I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for coming to watch me tonight, guys. Bye.